Welcome to this video. I welcome you all to my channel all about mechanical engineering. In the previous video we have studied what is a carburetor, where it is used, various types of carburetors, various forms of carburetors, and Solex carburetor was studied in detail. In today's video we'll study a Carter carburetor. What is a Carter carburetor? Basically it is an open choke type of carburetor. That is, it is similar to a Solex carburetor, but the arrangement is different. It employs downrod form of carburation. It is American-made carburetor manufactured by Carter Company, founded by William Carter in 1909. It was basically designed to be used in Jeeps. Now this is the diagram of a Carter carburetor. As we can see, it is a simple carburetor with some additional attachments. These attachments come into picture under various conditions. So, let us discuss each and every condition in detail one by one. Here, I have given color coding to have a better understanding. This blue color indicates fuel flow, brown color indicates air flow, and red color indicates air-fuel mixture flow. Now, the first condition which we have to study is cold starting and warming condition. As we all know, during cold starting, we need a richer mixture, that is at least 5 to 10 times richer as compared to normal running. During a cold start, when you are operating your choke, this is my choke number 2, we are blocking the incoming air and we are restricting it from entering into my system. So minimum amount of air is entering the carburetor. Here, the float chamber supplies fuel using this channel to jet number 4. Now the incoming air is less, but the suction is created by movement of piston inside the cylinder, and because of which suction pressure is created at this point. Thus, in order to cope up that pressure, here more amount of fuel is ejected or given out and is mixed with this incoming air. Here we have less amount of air, more amount of fuel, means we are forming a rich mixture, and that is required for our cold starting. This rich mixture is given from 3 to 5, 5 to 6, and from this 6 to the engine cylinder, and your engine gets started once it obtains a richer mixture. The moment your engine gets started, the choke we are using here is of semi-automatic type, means it automatically gets open to 50% of the value, thus allowing more amount of air into the carburetor. Now, once I have more amount of air coming inside, I have a lean mixture prepared as compared to previous. So this lean mixture is fed to the engine in order to have a warming condition. Now, idling and slow running. Idling is the condition which is defined as when you have engine running at no load, that is called as idling. Whereas when you have 0 to 20% of the load capacity, that is called as slow running condition. Now during idling, the float chamber supplies fuel to this channel to low speed jet in upward direction at this point. Now, when I have an idling condition, obviously I am not operating my throttle, means I am not accelerating. So the incoming air changes its path, rather flowing in downward direction. It takes this as a passage and enters at port number 11. This flowing air creates a suction at this point and takes some amount of fuel, and which is atomized in it, and forms an air fuel mixture, which is then taken in downward direction using this passage, and this air fuel mixture is given out at port number 9. As we can see, port number 9 is below throttle valve number 8. Even though you are not accelerating, you are not using throttle, your engine is getting some amount of air fuel mixture. Now when you have a slow running condition, means you have 0 to 20% of the load, obviously you are operating your throttle to some value. The moment you start accelerating, you are throttling, your air fuel mixture, rather than coming out from point number 9, it takes port number 12 and comes out from this port, because after opening the throttle, port number 12 gets connected with the engine. So this is how my idling and slow running circuits are working. Now normal running condition. When you have load capacity from 20% to 75%, that condition is called as normal running. During normal running, my choke is open, more amount of air is coming inside, this amount of air is flowing in downward direction because I have a load which is more than 20%, so obviously we are operating throttles, we are accelerating, so it is open. Once you have operated this throttle, the air takes vertically downward flow. Float chamber supplies fuel using this channel to port number 4, your jet number 4. So here, this fuel is getting mixed with this incoming air at number 3. Here you have atomization process which is partial. Then here when you have air fuel mixture prepared, you give it to 5, it flows in vertically downward direction. 5 is again getting some amount of additional air, so this air fuel mixture is again added with some amount of air and atomization process continues. And then from here it is traveling in downward direction to 6. Again some amount of air is coming and is getting mixed with this air fuel mixture. So we have atomization process at 3 different locations, means you have more chances of having complete atomization and you have minimum chances of having liquid fuel present in your system. This air fuel mixture is given using this direction to engine cylinder. So this is how you have normal running conditions. Now when you have a normal running condition and you are having gradual acceleration, this is a metering rod which is connected to accelerator pedal. So when you are gradually accelerating, this metering rod is raised, which increases the area of this metering rod jet, means you have more amount of opening available and more amount of fuel is allowed to flow to jet number 4. When you are deaccelerating, at that time this metering rod is lowered, thus decreasing the opening size and reducing the amount of fuel flow. This is how your carburetor works in a normal running condition. Now when you have a sudden acceleration, during sudden acceleration we need an additional amount of fuel in order to cope up with the increased amount of power requirement instantaneously. So along with your normal working of carburetor, means your petrol is supplied from float chamber to jet number 4 as discussed in previous normal landing condition, the same is happening here, but one thing is added. My accelerator pedal is connected to this acceleration pump setup. The moment I suddenly accelerate, this piston moves vertically in downward direction and the fuel which is present here is pumped through this 15 number line to port number 17. So I have an additional jet entering in my carburetor along with this normal running. So more amount of fuel is supplied. Now the moment sudden acceleration is finished, you are releasing your accelerator, means this piston is traveling in upward direction because of this spring force, thus creating a vacuum here and some amount of fuel from float chamber enters this channel and will be stored here, which will be utilized for next sudden acceleration. So this is how your Carter carburetor works under sudden acceleration conditions. This was all regarding Carter carburetor. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed.